Hey, welcome back to my channel. This is Pastor Sinclair, your kingdom baby girl, and welcome to February. Welcome to February, the month of love. I just want to say that I love you. Before I do anything and I get to anything, I just want to tell you that I love you. If you are new here, we talk all things faith, relationships, and family. And I promise you guys that in this month of February, we will be touching on relationships. But before we get into all of the juicy stuff and all the of the complicated stuff or about relationships, there is one greatest relationship that we all need to take care of, and that is the relationship with self. So that is the relationship with self. You need to love yourself first before you can expect love from anyone else, from your church, for example, from your spouse, from your boyfriend, from your partner, from your family members, from anybody else. So let's get right into the video of today. I am having coffee. I'm actually having my cappuccino this morning. And if you would like to know, this is my Carol Boys cup. I got it as a set for myself during Christmas because I was showing myself some love. And that's exactly what I'm talking about today, guys. But before we get in anything else, let's quickly get into the Word of God, because you know we are all faith-based. So there is no way that I will start the month without really getting into the Word of God. And yes, I am wearing glasses today because the baby girl is not so baby, so of a bit, so much baby anymore, and my eyesight was already started giving me problems. So let's quickly look into our Bibles. We're going to be reading from the book of Matthew chapter 22, and obviously if you follow me by now, you should know that I love my TPT version and my Message translations. I love the simpler versions of the Bible. So we're going to be reading from the book of Matthew chapter 22, and I am reading verses 36 to 40. This is Jesus, just a background story. This is Jesus talking to his disciples. Now his disciples then asked him a question. They said, "Teacher, which commandment in the law is the greatest?" And then Jesus answered them and he said, "Love the Lord your God with every passion of your heart, with all the energy of your being, and with every thought that is within you." Verses 38 says, "This is the great and supreme commandment." And 39, that's where we are going today. And then Jesus said to them, "And the second is like it in importance." So what I'm about to read now is as important as the first commandment. So Jesus says, "The second is like it in importance. You must love your neighbor. You must love your friend in the same way that you love yourself." Yes, in the same way that you love yourself. And verses 40 says, "Contained within these commandments to love, you will find all the meaning of the law and the prophets." That's just the word of the Lord. So this month of February, as much as we know that it is the month of love, and everybody, you know, love is blooming, love is blossoming. People that are in relationships, they're expecting gifts. Those that are not in relationships, they are feeling overwhelmed. The 14th is gonna hit and I'm still single. Those that are believing God for marriages are already panicking. They're asking God, why have I not gotten someone for myself, right? Let me just take this out. they are probably asking themselves, God, why have I not gotten someone? You know, those that are alone, the orphans are probably saying, oh wow, I don't have any parent. What kind of, who will show me the love during this month? So there is a lot. So, but I want to encourage you this morning that the greatest commandment is to love yourself. So take time this month, whether you have a partner or not, but take time to love yourself. Take time to love yourself. I love what Jesus says. He says, take time to love yourself with every passion of your heart. You see, that same love that you want to give out, begin to love yourself that way. That same love that you want to receive from someone else, begin to love yourself that way. Because by so doing, you will then begin to attract that thing that you so desire. And he says, with all the energy of your being. So put all your energy this month of February and going forward in loving yourself. What do you do? What then do you need to do? Spoil yourself. You know, if loving yourself means taking yourself out for coffee, you know, you can take yourself out for coffee. You can take yourself out for lunch. You can go and take yourself out for a spa date. You can buy yourself flowers. Yes, ladies. Guys, there is nothing wrong with you buying yourself flowers. You are showing yourself love. You are loving yourself with every energy of your being and with every thought that is within you. So, you know, as I was just meditating on the scripture even yesterday, I began to say that every thought, the things that we think of ourselves, you know, some of us, we talk so down on ourselves. We look down on ourselves. We begin to say, I'm not good enough. But this month of February, I want to encourage you to love yourself with every thought that you have. Begin to love yourself. Begin to speak domitable words. Begin to speak words that will dominate your spirit. Begin to speak words that will make you blossom up. I remember when I wanted, for example, I remember when I wanted, when I started the channel, right? I was just Pastor Zinkle. And then I clocked 40. As many of you do know that I am 40 years old. And then I said, no, but I'm a baby girl. And I began to say that. And I kept saying it. And I kept saying it. And I kept saying it. And I've built a brand now around that, that I am Pastor Zinkle, the baby girl. What was I doing? I was showing myself love. I did not want to speak words that will say I'm old or I'm raggedy or I've gone through this or I'm broken. No, I wanted to say that I deserve the good things of life. I deserve the best things of life. And I am seeing that being attracted to me right now, right? I am seeing it without even me struggling for them. The good things, they are just, you know, they are drawn to me. So, for example, if you're somebody that wants money, loads of money, you know, begin to call yourself that you are loaded, you are beautiful, you are kinging, you are a king, you are a priest, you are a love child of a love God. Begin to speak words of love. Begin to love yourself with all your being. Before you expect someone else to show you love, before you expect someone else to demonstrate love to you, begin to demonstrate love to yourself. And as I round off, love yourself enough to also put boundaries. Boundaries are so important, guys. Love yourself enough to also put boundaries. Boundaries. You can create boundaries on how even you use social media, right? Because social media can influence you. There are so many things that you can get on social media that will dampen your spirit, that will make you look like I am not good enough, that will make you look like I don't have that good body. You know, I don't have those good features. I don't have that big house. I don't have that big car. Because Social media will never show you the ugly. Let me tell you, social media will never show you the ugly of it. It will only show you the good, right? And whether that good, how it's gotten, they will not get into details. But this month of love, this month of February, I want to encourage you to love yourself first with all of your heart, with all of your passion, with all of your being. Spoil yourself. Take yourself out. Go out on a date. Go and date yourself before you can expect anyone to date you. Take yourself out on a date. And I hope and I pray that this month will bring so much love into your life. As you begin to practice loving yourself, you will so draw much love towards yourself. And I pray that the love of God will be so manifested in your life this month of February like never before. You will experience God like the comforter. Many of you, I hear the Spirit of God says that you are looking for someone who will comfort you. But I am here to declare to you and decree to you that this month of February, you will experience God like the comforter that He is, like the advocate that He is, like the helper that He is, like the healer that He is, like the extraordinary strategist that He is. So everything that you need, you will find it in yourself first before you can go out. I hope that this word has blessed you. I want to pray for you. I want to pray that February be a month of testimonies, be a month of results. May you come back with results. May you come back with results of love. May you come back, but more than anything, with the result of the love of God. And if you do not know Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior of your love or of your life, make sure that by the end of this video, you commit yourself, you give yourself to Him, you surrender your life to Him. You are here because of His love. Remember, I love you guys. And if you have not joined this family, make sure that you join the tribe. We are growing slowly but surely by the love of God. I am seeing the love of God manifest in my life every single way. Right, every single corner, I see the love of God. It surrounds me. When I walk, I know that I'm not alone because I know that I have someone that is walking with me, the omnipresent one. He is walking with me. So guys, make sure that you hit that subscribe button. If you have not joined this family, share this video. Let's encourage someone. There are some people, you know, there's the rate of suicides, guys. I didn't even want to talk about that. The rate of suicides these days, it is alarming. Why? It is because people are waiting for the world to show them love, and they don't know that it begins with them. I love you guys. Until tomorrow, I will see you. Stay blessed. This is Pastor Zinke, the Kingdom Baby Girl. Until next time, bye-bye.